Good morning, children. Sai Ram. Today we will start with a poem. That is poem number 7, Where the Mind is Without Fear. It is written by Rabindranath Tagore. This poem will be taken in 2 parts. Let's start with the first part today. Be ready with a pen and a notebook to jot down the difficult words, their meanings, and figures of speech we are going to discuss here. Before actually starting the poem, let us discuss some thoughts. Our nation can work together and make significant growth only if we all work collectively and create a positive learning environment for each other. Sometimes we as individuals are not able to give our best because we are shadowed by our fear, anger, and any other limitation. Children, here is a picture of thought bubbles given in front of you. I would like to overcome. Now, what you would like to overcome? What you would like to control? Sometimes you find that children are very short-tempered. Sometimes they are indisciplined. So you can say yes, and you know that it is not good. So you can say that yes, I would like to overcome the habit of being short-tempered or the habit of being indisciplined. But some children have the fear of darkness or height or sometimes fear of water. So you can write that I would like to overcome this fear. Right? There is no illusion greater than fear. So fear is the greatest illusion. It is illusion. It is not a reality. It is a false belief. Do you know about Arunima Sinha, who was pushed from train? She lost both her legs and had multiple fractures in her spinal cord. Anybody else in her place would have lost all hope, but she got the guts and climbed several mountains. So she has controlled or she has overcome the illusion that she won't be able to walk or climb the mountains. Same way here, the poet says that people should overcome the illusion of fear and of all the other habits so that they can bring the best in them. Now let us study about the great poet Rabindranath Tagore, who wrote Where the Mind is Without Fear. He lived in the period 1861 to 1941. Was a Bengali polymath, a poet, a musician, an artist who reshaped the Bengali literature and music, as well as Indian art, in the late 19th and early 20th centuries. Author of Gitanjali and its profoundly sensitive, fresh and beautiful verse, he became in 1913 the first non-European to win the Nobel Prize in Literature. He is sometimes referred to as the Bard of Bengal. that is the poet of Bengal. Gitanjali is a book of poems. It was written in Bengali language and was translated in many other languages. Gitanjali means songs offerings. Where the Mind is Without Fear is a pre-independent poem in which the poet sincerely urges to God to awake his fellow beings for the realization that the essential need to live in a free and unified country. He wants his countrymen to awake and enjoy the life of full dignity and honor. Where the mind is without fear. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where knowledge is free, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls, where words come out from the depth of truth, where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert sand of dead habit, where the mind is led forward by thee into ever widening thought and action, into that heaven of freedom, my Father, let my country awake. Now let us start with the explanation of the poem. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high. In these lines, the poet starts to imagine what he would like his country to be. He says that no countryman of his should live with fear on his mind at all times. Instead, they should hold their heads up fearlessly and have confidence in themselves. Where knowledge is free, that means knowledge should be freely available to all citizens. That is, educational institute should admit students of all races and classes. Why does he say? Because in the pre-independence period, education was not free for all. So he prays that the country, that is India, should have knowledge freely available to all people. Where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls. That means all the various regions of India and the people should be united instead of fighting amongst themselves for supremacy. They should fight together against a common enemy to determine their common fate. So here, fragment means a small part of something that has broken off or comes from something larger. So what kind of fragments is being referred here? These fragments are the groups of people in India who are different due to their religion, caste, creed or class, and who breaks the world. These are the narrow domestic walls. These walls are of differences and division between people. So he says that he wants that freedom of India where there will be no fragments, no division between different people, and people will be united they will not fight against each other. Where words come out from the depth of truth. In these lines, the poet says that in the India of his dreams, everyone should speak the truth. No person should lie for his own advantage. Now let us see the literary devices used in the poem. The poem is free verse. Now what do you mean by free verse? Free verse means poetry that does not rhyme and does not have a regular rhythm. So we do not have any rhyme scheme in this poem. Let's learn the figures of speech used. The head is held high. It is alliteration. That is repetition of the sound of the letter H. That is, H sound is repeated. Now, this line is also metaphor. How? Metaphor, you have already studied that when two things are indirectly compared, is said to be the same. Here, assuming proud posture is indirectly compared to that of independent India, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls. What is the figure of speech? Metaphor. Here the walls of narrow-minded thinking like ignorance, hatred, prejudices, caste system are indirectly compared to wall. Children, whatever we have studied in this part, let us have a quick recap. In the poem, Where the Mind is Without Fear, Tagore sketches a moving picture of the nation he would like India to be, where everyone within the fold of the brotherhood is free to hold up one's head high and one's voice to be heard without any tension or fear of oppression or forced compulsion, where the knowledge is not restricted by narrow ideas and loyalties. The British rule had robbed India of its pride and dignity by reducing it to a subject nation. The India of Tagore's dream is a country where her people hold their heads high with their pride in knowledge and strength born of that knowledge, where all countrymen must come out the age-old world of people who have lost the vision of one humanity by the narrow loyalties of caste, creed, and religion. Prejudice and superstition, which narrow the mind and divide people, would be a thing of the past. Where the words of truth come out from the depths of the heart and are spoken out courageously in the open for the world to hear. With this, we come to the end of today's session. The remaining part of the poem will be taken in the next video. Till then, goodbye. Take care.